Hi, my name is Vikramjit Singh and welcome to my channel Education Just Ahead. Friends, in this video we will learn about swap space, what is swap space and how we can extend the swap space with the help of partition. Swap space in Linux is used when the amount of physical memory is full and if the system needs more memory resources and the RAM is full. Then inactive pages from the RAM are automatically moved to the swap space, and once the RAM is free, once the RAM is available, then inactive pages from the swap will move from swap space to RAM. It should not be considered as replacement of RAM because swap space is a virtual memory. Swap space is located on hard disk which have slower access than RAM. So there are multiple ways by which we can increase the swap space. So in this video I am going to show you how you can increase the swap space with the help of partition. So first of all, let's see the available swap space. Free-h is a command that you can use to view the available swap space. Here you can see that 2 GB is available, use 0 byte, and free is 2 GB. So it's clearly saying that 2 GB swap space is available for me that I can use. So here now I'm going to extend the swap space. So for that, first of all we need to add a partition. Let's see the available partition. Here you can see that I have two partition, SDA1 and SDA2. Here I'm going to add one more partition, fdisk.sda. This asking command M for help. Here you can type M if you want to take any help. N add a new partition. Here I'm going to add a new partition. Type N, P primary, E extended. I'm going to add a extended partition. Okay, fine. Extended partition has been successfully added. Okay, fine. It's better now. Now again type N to create the logical partition, because earlier we have created the extended partition. Now I'm going to create logical partition within the extended partition. Type L to create the logical, and please keep in mind that will be my fifth partition. First sector it should be blank, and last sector should be, suppose that I'm going to create a 500 MB partition. M. Here you can see the partition 5, type Linux, and size of 5 MB is set. So means my new partition has been added. Type W to save the partition table. Now let's see if it is showing in the list or not. Yep, it is available. So this is my swap space, swap partition that I am going to use to extend my swap space. So there is a command like mkswap, and the partition name like SDA5 is the partition name that you can use. It will take some time. It is saying no such file or directory. I think we need to restart because my partition table is not updated yet. So let's take a fast reboot. Reboot -f. So now it's rebooting. Friends, right now I'm just going to push the video to save the time. And once my system is up, then I will get back to you. Okay, fine. My system is up. Now let's see if. Okay, fine. Now let's try once again to create the swap. MK swap slash dev sda5. Okay, fine. So our swap has been successfully created. Now in the command that we have to use swap on slash dev sda5 to activate the swap. Swap on. Okay. Oh, there is an issue. SD, it should be sda5, not SD. Yep, it's fine. Now let's check the swap space once again. Here you can see that initially it was 2.0 means 2 GB, now it is showing 2.4 GB. So it clearly means that our partition, our swap space has been extended. Here one thing we should keep in mind, that if we will reboot, then our swap space will be gone, the earlier we have created. And if you want to make it available after the reboot, then we have to make entry in the etcfs tab. Okay, fine. Like here, dev sda5 partition name, and then this swap, and then again swap default setting and 0 and 0 we have to choose. Fine. I think it's enough for today. In this video I showed you how you can create the swap space. If you like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.